Here we are off on another adventure. We stayed the night at Mole Creek like we did a little while ago. It's a great Western Tees. All cloudy and misty last night, but woke up to a really, really big frost. Old tram line here. Nice and cool. Mole Creek pub. Fantastic meals. Accommodation, clean and basic. Everything you need. Meals, bloody fantastic. Great food. We're heading out into the walls of Jerusalem. Forecast later today is for rain and snow above 1,000 metres, and we're going to be up 12, 1300. So, yeah, it should be interesting, and we're looking forward to it. Here we are at the Mersey River again, into the walls of Jerusalem. We've still got about 15 or 18 kilometres to go. It's a beautiful spot. Blue skies at the moment. It's going to be another good day. Just arrived at the walls of Jerusalem car park. This is the registration shelter. Toilets. Fair bit's changed since I was last here. It was about 25, 26 years ago. Bigger car park, obviously, gets more use. Come the bluff, up over there in the distance. We've got the old boiler back.
Taking some Panadol.
Panadol's already got a headache.
Yeah.
It's going to be a great day. Sun's out, blue sky. And packed a heap of wet weather gear, winter camping. Got to have it. What are we doing here, old girl?
We are signing Sim.
Yep.
So they know that we're here because we've booked the walk in advance. One day.
Yep, and we've got our trip intentions, car rego, stuff like that, number of party.
I can see why it's not like the paper.
That's because it's damp.
Yeah, because it gets really damp.
Yep, and the date we're expected to return. Yeah. Right here. Yeah. Walk up to southeast towards Trappers. The weather's good, we'll walk right into the walls. And through the walls into Dixon's Kingdom.
So we're doing Dixon's Kingdom return?
Yep. Boot cleaning station. Don't want to carry any gremlins into this national park.
Wild Creek, Tempest Pool, Lento's there.
We're going to be heading uphill the next 40 minutes to an hour. This is up to Trapper's Hut, and then we'll have a spell and move on. What are you expecting, Kathy?
A hard slog to begin with. Hopefully some bloody good snow. I'd like to wake up in the snow.
Yep.
And some awesome views.
Yeah. Bit of luck, we'll get all that.
All of that, we should do, shouldn't
yeah,
we?
Yeah, yeah. We'll go over this first hour and then recess and go again.
Cool.
Just got to our first major stop, Trapper's Hut. It's probably a bit over 2Ks. Uphill to the southeast from the car park. It's a beautiful old hut. Seen plenty of bushwalker, hiker. So slab, timber slab where they, I suppose they used to put all their game inside. So just rustic. How do you expect to find an old trapper's hut? Actually spent a night on that bed very, very long time ago. It's one of the coldest nights of my life. It's much warmer in a tent. It's open end, it's where the smoke used to escape when they had fires in here once upon a time. Lots of history on the boards. It's great to see that this part of the Trapper's Hut history has not been lost. Looks like it's very well maintained, looked after. Exactly how it should be. We've come a couple hundred metres uphill south of Trapper's Hut. We've come to a sign, truck junction. The walls on the left, which is where we're heading, Lake Adelaide on the right hand side. Actually does form a big part of a loop, but we're in and out of the walls this time. We're just going past a place called Solomon's Jewels. Up here, see very much, sun's out. Have a
small lake over there. About half frozen over. Not fully, it's a little bit windy. But yeah, definitely been cold up here. Another sort of the southern end of Solomon's Jewels. Really, really nice place. You can see up over the top up over here. That's where we go. Up in a valley just to the left hand side there. That gets you right into the walls. So obviously going in the right direction. Sun's still out. It's fairly flat going now, isn't it? Much better. Much better than the climb. Yeah. Yeah, the first hour and a half, 2 hours?
2 hours probably.
Yeah, pretty challenging.
It was challenging.
Yeah.
It takes much easier.
It is. A few ups and downs, but yeah. Find our way pretty right and enjoy it while we're going. Right, I've just come across a little stream. Put a boardwalk over it. But I don't know, there's just something wrong with my eyes, because that to me looks like it's going uphill.
Yeah, it is going uphill.
It looks like it's going uphill, doesn't it?
Maybe it's going down to the next one, over there.
There's a lake over there.
Yeah.
It's obviously going down, but...
it looks like it's going uphill.
It looks like it's going uphill. It's crazy. We've just wandered into Wild Dog Creek campsite. A little bit of breeze here, so hopefully you can hear me. It's a tappy. Very civilised. There's a creek just over the back here. Tent platforms, there's four here. And I suppose I'd each accommodate a couple of two-person or three-person tents. Hello.
Hello.
Do you want to go up to the next one? Might be a little bit more sheltered.
Yep.
It's only just up the track a bit, I think.
Cool.
I'm pretty exposed here. The weather turns nasty. It comes in from the west, northwest. Wouldn't be much fun, I don't think. Found some boardwalk now to help protect the environment. See people spreading out and making big muddy tracks. No, Lockie would like it, but it's not the point.
Couple different spots.
Yeah, okay.
That's right at the top.
Yep. Right, we might go up the middle one and see if there's a bit of shelter there.
Yep.
Have some lunch.
Okay.
What do you feel like?
Lunch.
All right.
Lunch, whatever I've got in my bag.
Righto, just here we go. Here we are, we found ourselves a platform to have lunch. We actually decided to have a hot lunch because it's a bit cold. As soon as we finish walking, we'll put our beanies on and our coats, keep a bit of warmth in, and the wind is pretty bloody cold. Looks like the weather has started to change a little bit. And we'll wait till after lunch and see what happens and make some plans. I'm going to have some 2 minute noodles and some Vita Wheat and peanut butter.
Hot chocolate, Vita Wheats.
Lunch. It's come to track a little bit. This looks awesome.
Awesome.
Seven, 8 platforms. Maybe a hammock. Outdoor area, water. Unfortunately, the pipe's obviously frozen and it's got a split in it. Look at this. This is pretty bloody good. Obviously, lots of expense, but at the same time, in a beautiful spot, looking after the environment. It's up off the ground. There's no warm patches or anything like that. I think it's great. This is basically our first glimpse of coming into the walls. Massive wind tunnel just coming through the Herald's Gate there. It's really cold. Still on the track. Weather's come in a bit, it's all misty. Stuff's gonna be damp, we're gonna stop in a minute. But it's all sheltered. See exactly where we are, where we need to go. Put a wet weather's on. It's swirling all up there. Just go near these, the pencil pines or trees over here. We found a nice little sheltered spot amongst the pines. You camp here at a pinch, it's reasonably sheltered. Isn't it cold wind and well, it's not really sleet yet, is it? It's just grey cloud more than anything. Cramp.
Yep.
Time for wet leathers. Only fallen over once.
Got a wet ass.
Wet ass. Well, it's actually because there's still a fair bit of ice on the track. I mean, it's half past 2 in the afternoon, there's still ice on the tracks. So, yeah, you know it's pretty cold when the ice doesn't melt during the day. Anyway, I'm going to have a look at the map, find out exactly where we are and where we need to go.
That. Come past here.
Yep, we had lunch. Lunch here at Wild Dog Creek.
Yep. Come up here.
That's a big lake on our left. Lake Solon.
I'm looking at this big peak here.
Yep, that is.
And then it comes down in here.
That is Solomon's Throne.
Is that here?
Yep.
So we're not far. Are we back here?
Well, we've just come into a patch of
trees. There's trees, so we'd be in here.
We are exactly in there. Yep.
Cool.
So
it must be going off there.
So the pool,
to the pool.
Or the pool over here somewhere,
yep.
A little truck. We need to go up to this gate, Damascus Gate.
Yep.
Down through Pensa Pines or Kinvilly Pines and over the Dixon's Kingdom Hut. So point the map in roughly the right direction. There's a fair chance.
It's over there.
It is out through there. That's what it tells me. Yeah. The saddle of Damascus Gate. The last 700 or 800 metres downhill. I believe to one of the largest stands of Kinvilly Pine left in the world, so we're going to enjoy this. Very eerie in here, isn't it?
It is.
Silent. Massive old trees, old pines. Sky's turned a little bit of a little shade of blue. I may be wrong. God forbid I've been known to be wrong. I reckon we're going to get snow out of that direction over there. Feels like it. It's bloody cold, isn't it?
It's bloody cold.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just coming down into Dixon's Kingdom. Massive old trees. Lots of rock on the track. They're formed out of some rocks. Lots of ice on it. Very, very dangerous. Be very careful. And it's coming out into the clearing. I thought the clouds lifted a little bit down here. Maybe it's just a bit thicker up higher. Looks like we found a hut. Dixon's Kingdom Hut. Absolutely beautiful. Look at that. Never been in here this far before. Beautiful little plane. Some toilets up there, which is fantastic. G'day, mate. How you doing? Good. Trapper's Hut's that way, just where we come through this morning, Mount Jerusalem. Found up over there somewhere. Anyway, this is a pretty cool looking hut. Found in many a photo. Lots of history again. Very well worn. Nice sheltered spot in amongst all these trees. Beautiful. Let's look inside the hut. It's a bit dark. Probably fit 3 or 4 people on a bed platform there. Bit of a table, logbook. We'll have a look at that shortly. Bit of a pinch, you can use it as an emergency shelter. Around here, a board. Lots of information on it. Like Trapper's Hut. Alright, we'll pop out here, wait for Kathy. And find somewhere to
turn up.
Here you are, old boiler. It's dangerous coming down those rocks, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, a couple of them I avoided.
Yeah.
That's for sure.
Yeah.
Bloody ice.
Here in one piece is good.
Yeah.
We've got the tents up. Not real sure which way the weather's supposed to come, but a little bit away from the tree, so hopefully we're safe. A little four-season tents. Great little tents. Yours is a bit more camo than mine. Mine sticks out like dog's nuts, but yeah, well, that's right, you can be seen, but sometimes you don't want to be seen either. Inside, haven't put anything in here yet, but the comfy, the warm, it's going to be dry, so you can't wait to get in there tonight. A bit dark in the hut here at Dixon's Kingdom, but we've set up camp.
We're drinking port.
We're having a port, reward for effort.
Yep.
By Pete, some peen ham soup.
In my cup.
Cup.
Probably can't.
Can't see anything.
There you go.
Hike more, worry less. It's pretty cool, isn't it? Do a great job of that. So yeah, so peen ham soup and some Vita Wheat and peanut butter again. It's like a staple diet. For tea tonight, roast lamb and veggies. Apparently Jenna doesn't like that. She spat it out. But I hope you don't mind it when you're cold and hungry. It's nice and warm and fills you up. So it's all good. You can't really see much in here, can you?
No.
What are your thoughts on today?
It was hard work. I know my fitness levels are not where they should be. So that's something I've got to work on.
You don't really expect to carry a pack up 500 metres in elevation.
You don't.
Every single day.
It was hard. It was. But I'm here and that's the main thing.
Yeah. No, we kept going. We climbed to the top of the saddle where King David's peak is in Lake Salome, and we said the weather's a bit shitty. We made a choice of whether we go past the point of no return.
And we did.
We did. So after that, we head back to Wild Dog Creek and camp on the platforms. I'm glad we did.
Because we came all this way and we're not going to miss it.
Exactly right. And I've never been here, Dixon's Kingdom, and it's a beautiful little spot. Really old rustic hut. And we're in here out of the elements and having something to eat and quite drink. What are you washing it down with?
That.
Bailey's.
And hot chocolate.
Surname is Bailey. Drink Bailey's.
Yeah, exactly.
What's for tea?
Chicken tikka masala.
Masala.
Hey, check out this.
You've had this before.
Yeah, I know. Look at the chicken. Oh. How exciting is that?
Jen would love that, wouldn't she?
She would.
Tastes like that.
And there's no peas.
No peas. She would love that too.
No peas.
I got roast lamb. Had that before, tried out on Jan, and tastes like cardboard.
It's got mint in it.
I have the roast lamb. Put your spud in there. Really, really good.
Oh mate, Boston might like the spud.
Not sure whether he's worthy of them or not. I'm not going to leave him in my pack, that's for sure. It's really good. Nice and warm, fills the belly up. And what is it? 5:30, quarter to six.
It is. Let's have a look. Ooh, quarter to six.
Is it?
Yeah.
Weather's shitty outside.
Must be bedtime.
Drizzling and cold and a bit windy, but in the hut here, it's actually pretty comfy. I'm a little bit disappointed to put my tent up. I actually could have been sleeping over there. I had old mate Grey Possum over there with me as well, but anyway. It's not a bad bed platform. And finished tea. Looks like the window's all frozen up. Someone's trying to burn something now. I don't know why you bother doing that. This old log cabin hut's been here for a bloody long time. Lantern there, so we'll see what we're doing. Old boiler just finished up. Old mate's just gone to bed in his tent. He's from Launceston. We've had our possum in here tonight. What is it, 6:10? 10 past 6?
It is 6:08, yes.
6:08, there we go. Yep, let's sit here for another half hour and it'll be bedtime, I reckon. Having the tent and the weather. We've been warm in the tent. All season, the tent nice and cosy. Taking your lollies to bed?
Yeah, I'm trying to warm them up in my hands so I can actually eat them because they're solid. So it's saying something, isn't it?
What's that temperature gauge say now?
It says...
It's just up in there.
It's still just above zero. It's probably about 2 or 3 degrees.
And that's in here. Three of us have been cooking tea and stuff, so it's probably warmer than what it should be. About 10 in the morning, it's going to be in the negatives. Oh! Why don't you say hello? You dirty bitch. Well, that'll warm it up. You're straight under the thermometer. I hope the draft isn't blowing my way. Actually, I hope you shit yourself.
No, I won't.
That's terrible.
Says he.
Yeah, have a look.
Yeah, look at the bar drop. Jeez, he's wet. Look, he's pulling at the zips.
Off.
Hey mate, he's pulling your zip open. Look, holy shit!
He's in the zip. Look at that. Right, out. Get out.
He's blind in one eye.
Doesn't mean you're allowed to eat my zip.
Wow. Hey mate. He's in really good condition. It's because he eats out of packs all the time.
That's unreal.
Is that? Oh, that's still on. another go at the zip. Bar jars. Yeah, look. He's stuffed.
He's done that 100 times before.
He has. Look at him get into it.
Nothing much better than found a bit of a night in the tent, listening to the rain after a hard day's walk. It's cold, it's warm in the tent, it's cold outside, it's raining, but listening to the rain on the tent is something different. You always have a good night's sleep when you listen to really good rain in the tent. We've been on the bit, good gas and bad gas. You've got to have four season stuff. So out here you've got the cheap stuff, it's not going to work properly, and you're not going to be able to cook up a hot meal or a hot drink or anything like that. So spend that little bit extra on good gas and it'll be nice and tasty. People wonder why we do this stuff, why we do it to ourselves, but it's challenging. You have the right gear, you're a bit more comfortable, really nice views. At the back of Walkwalk, you just come from up in there. You see the Wailing Wall, West Wall, still a fair bit of cloud there. Tracks very much like this. You got a nice bit of snow, gotta be really, really careful. A couple of local fellas over here. Probably used to seeing hikers. Pretty hardy sort of souls to be out here in the middle of winter. I guess they're used to it. It's about midday. We've just got back down over the crest of the hill into Trappers. We're just going to have some lunch. Out here in the sun is quite pleasant, really. Did notice that the last people that we've met on the track, obviously, have come in the hut for a look. Left the bloody door open. You know, they please themselves what they do, but what it does, it encourages wildlife to get in here. If the wind blows the door shut when the wildlife is in here, they get really distressed. So when you leave the hut, shut the bloody door and it'll keep all the wildlife safe. A couple little things about our walk. Obviously the weather's changed for the good after we've sort of come out. I've not used a couple of these things before, but I found them really, really good. What about you?
The mats. Oh my God, like where we've stopped to eat and it's been bloody cold, and even last night in that hut,
yeah,
it's just the insulation for your butt.
Yeah,
it's and a big difference.
It's a cheap little foamy. I think it costs 10 bucks. We cut a couple of squares off it and enough just to enough to sit on.
Yeah.
And it's actually really, really, not super warm, but it actually stopped your bum from getting cold if you didn't have it.
And I used my bit underneath my body as well last night.
In the tent?
Yep.
Yeah. Other little thing, I've bought a few of my boys used them, and I think Kathy's used them before, is it the little hand warmers.
Oh, that was terrific. And you got the two hand warmers, but I've got this supersized one. And body warmer.
It costs bugger all.
$2.
Really, really handy.
And last night in that tent, water's boiling, Jace.
Water's boiling. Oh, let's turn it off. And
last night at 10 I ducked that, put that over, you know, different parts of my body that was cold.
Yep.
And then later on when I was warm I just tucked it down the back of my pants and it stayed there all night.
You won't even blow a hole in it.
Nearly blowed a hole in it. I heard you farting. I was fine.
Yeah. But this morning when we put the tents away, it was like minuses. It was icy. It was cold. Tents were frozen. Pulling out pegs and you've got freezing cold hands. You can't feel your hands at all. And then you put your hands in your pockets and grab a hold of these warmers. It makes a really, really big difference. So just a couple of little things that actually helps make a winter trip a little bit more comfy.
Just got back to the car park at the base of Walls of Jerusalem, the base of the walking track. Beautiful and sunny. We've had the four seasons in the 2 days. It's quite pleasant right now. It's pretty warm actually. What I did notice, and it's bloody annoying really, is that about half a dozen young people up above Trapper's Hut, probably halfway into the Walls of Jerusalem. Late teens, early 20s, obviously going for a walk. I had a chat to them. They're actually walking into the Walls of Jerusalem themselves. So, you know, it's 7 or 8 k's into there. Between the six of them, they had two Coles bags, probably with a drink and a snack bar in them. No other gear in case, just in case the weather turned bad. I've just had a look in the logbook. There's absolutely no party of six there. There's no rego for that car. It's really disappointing because something went pear-shaped out there. They'd be left out there without any proper food, any shelter, any good clothing. Someone would have to come back and rescue them. Rescue people be up there risking their lives for people that are actually not doing the right thing. It's really bloody disappointing. And we see it a lot on our trips. It doesn't take much to get a decent backpack, a little bit of wet weather gear, maybe a little bit of decent food and some warm clothes and carry it. Otherwise, you know, shit can hit the fan really quick. So, old boiler, here she is. Great work, well done.
You're fresh as a daisy.
Yeah, you do now, we're back.
Yeah,
the sun's out now, it's unreal.
I know, it's great.
Yeah.
It's kind of warm.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, I just said that a minute ago.
We'll find out when we get in the car.
Yeah, I know. Well, yeah, we will. We got the temperature in there. Yeah, but I'm looking forward to a beer too. I think we've deserved it.
Well, you'll get a beer.
Yeah. You have a soft drink.
Bugger.
Cold water.
Creek.
All right, well done.
Did you find us out?
Yeah. Send me in the way. Send me in the way. Send me in the way. Send me in my.